I wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you personally for all the wonderful messages of support and for your understanding whilst I've been recovering from surgery. It has been an incredibly tough couple of months for our entire family, but I've had a fantastic medical team who have taken great care of me, for which I'm so grateful. In January, I underwent major abdominal surgery in London, and at the time, it was thought that my condition was non-cancerous. The surgery was successful. However, tests after the operation found cancer had been present. My medical team therefore advised that I should undergo a course of preventative chemotherapy, and I'm now in the early stages of that treatment. This, of course, came as a huge shock, and William and I have been doing everything we can to process and manage this privately for the sake of our young family. As you can imagine, this has taken time. It has taken me time to recover from major surgery in order to start my treatment. But most importantly, it has taken us time to explain everything to George, Charlotte and Louis in a way that's appropriate for them and to reassure them that I'm going to be okay. As I've said to them, I am well and getting stronger every day by focusing on the things that will help me heal in my mind, body and spirits. Having William by my side is a great source of comfort and reassurance too, as is the love, support and kindness that has been shown by so many of you. It means so much to us both. We hope that you'll understand that as a family, we now need some time, space and privacy while I complete my treatment. My work has always brought me a deep sense of joy, and I look forward to being back when I'm able. But for now, I must focus on making a full recovery. At this time, I'm also thinking of all those whose lives have been affected by cancer. For everyone facing this disease, in whatever form, please do not lose faith or hope. You are not alone.
英国凯特王妃持续神隐，各种传闻却越来越多。英国媒体《每日镜报》报道，凯特今年一月进行腹部手术时，病历遭到医院员工偷看。A
member of staff tried to access an area of the system which they don't have access to, trying to reach the princess's medical records while she was in hospital for surgeries.
这间叫做伦敦诊所的高级医院以保护病人的隐私出名，连查尔斯国王也是在这里动手术。没想到发生严重的个资外泄，据传已经有三名员工遭到停职。And
there's really strict rules. The information commissioner would take enforcement action against trusts or primary care practices.
英国讯息监管局已经开始调查偷看凯特病历的医院员工，恐怕将要面临刑责。不过凯特迟迟没有现身，各种阴谋论持续流传。You
will find people who are willing to try to satisfy that hunger in other ways than just speculating. For example, by trying to access information that they really don't have any business looking at.
被点名是威廉王储小三的罗斯也透过律师表示，传言完全都是假的。英国《每日电讯报》也提到，凯特密友透露，现在传言满天飞，凯特有可能为了平息混乱，提早在3月31日复活节的时候亮相。TVBS 新闻综合报道。 英国王储威廉出席支持无家可归者的活动，他被问到儿童的学前教育，脱口而出的却是这个名字。这是凯特王妃手术后，威廉王子第一次在镜头前公开提到太太，只是外界关心的恐怕还是凯特的健康状况。 英国《太阳报》上周六捕捉到凯特穿着休闲与威廉外出购物的影片，英国人普遍为凯特的恢复感到开心。It's
great to see her back in the public and showing her face, and so everybody knows that she's doing fine.
I do think people should just leave them to get on with their lives. Even that photo in the paper, they got nothing else to write about.
不过，王室专家认为，既然凯特的身影已经被拍到，王室可能会按照惯例冷处理。The
feeling really is that they're just simply not going to dignify this sort of wild speculation with any official comment.
只是经历了修图门事件，也有网友质疑，影片中的人真的是凯特吗？现在各种阴谋论四起，也让王室的信用越降越低。 外媒更发现，肯辛顿宫在去年四月释出的另一张王室照片，似乎也有修图的痕迹。
Of Queen Elizabeth with 10 of her grandchildren, or great-grandchildren, shot in 2022. CNN analysis finding signs that it was altered in as many as 19 places.
从手术后神隐到发表修图过的照片引发争议，这场由凯特而起的王室之乱，恐怕会让英国的八卦媒体非常开心。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
Здравствует Россия！
俄罗斯总统普京开心庆祝胜选，同一时间，俄罗斯媒体却疯传这条假新闻。社群网站上突然流传一张像是英国白金汉宫的声明，内容写查尔斯国王突然在昨天下午过世，下方还煞有其事标注发布时间为3月18号。
Another weekend, another series of fake online rumors. This time drawing a firm response from Buckingham Palace.
由于俄国多家新闻网一度跟进报道，逼得英国驻乌克兰和驻俄使馆紧急出面澄清，只是许多人还是担心查尔斯的健康。
The 75th anniversary of the Commonwealth is a moment to reflect on the remarkable journey.
查尔斯日前公开现身，已看得出面容憔悴不少。最近一张新公布的照片更被发现出现香肠手，疑似有水肿的问题。英国媒体《太阳报》满版标题写着很开心再次见到你，原来是独家直击凯特王妃术后现身，和威廉一起外出购物。
Tonight, Kensington Palace finally acknowledging new images of what appears to be Kate Middleton out shopping with Prince William.
凯特王妃神隐好几个月，又惹出修图风波，法新社直言肯辛顿宫不再是可信赖的消息来源。
This is the smallest crisis that the royal family has ever faced.
还有网友继续对最新拍到的购物照提出质疑，指出照片中威凯两人肩膀高度差异和过去明显不同，怀疑照片中女子可能并非凯特本尊。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
It's the question that has taken over the internet.Where is Kate Middleton?
Everyone is still talking about this picture.
Where do you stand on Kate's spirit?
英国凯特王妃到底在哪里？在修图照片被抓包之后，凯特的健康状况更令外界好奇。
They really, really messed up.
They really have messed up.
They have messed up.
Did you feel you were tricked?
Yes.
CNN 访问最先撤下照片的法新社照片总监，他认为漏洞百出的修图照重创了大众对王室的信任。
Our position now will be that every image, still image coming out of Kensington Palace will clearly be scrutinized very thoroughly.Before we decide to put it out to our subscribers around the world.
凯特的修图门引来骂声，但仍有不少英国民众表达力挺。
There's a lot bigger issues to worry about in the world, really, but people should just leave her alone.
It's blown out of all proportion. She did a little couple of tweaks at home. End of story.
至于凯特会神隐到什么时候，英国媒体报道，凯特的密友透露，可能会在4月23号，路易王子生日当天首度公开亮相。这时，哈利王子的太太梅根则是暌违6年开设了新事业的 IG 账号，要做什么生意还不清楚，但时间点、目的都非常的奇人异动。3天内还吸引了多达50万人追踪。
Like I am seriously impressed with the work that you do, especially at the young age that you're at.
而哈利和威廉则分别现身母亲戴安娜慈善机构的2场不同活动，在负面话题围绕王室之际，加上父王查尔斯持续休养当中，王子现在只能继续撑场面。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
英国威廉王储和小朋友们打成一片，一起做饼干。装饰饼干提到太太凯特，不过公开活动她还是独自参加，凯特继续神隐。凯特动腹部手术后就没有出现在公开场合，威廉现身妈妈戴安娜慈善基金活动，她也没有出现。
She taught me that everyone has the potential to give something back, that everyone indeed deserves a supporting hand in life. That legacy.Is something that both Catherine and I sought to focus on through our work.
几天前，凯特照片修图风波后，各种阴谋论甚嚣尘上。有人猜测凯特罹患饮食失调，或是去动臀部整形手术。最夸张的传闻是威廉有外遇，小三是凯特的闺蜜罗斯，甚至传言罗斯意外怀孕，以子逼宫，和凯特发生肢体冲突，导致凯特腹部被刀子刺伤。 照片里凯特旁边的就是八卦报传说的小三罗斯·汉伯里，他其实是凯特的好朋友，经常跟威廉夫妇一起现身。不过英国媒体报道各种传言让凯特心情沮丧，媒体甚至把凯特和阴谋论两个字合成新单字 Katespiracy 凯特阴谋论。
Why would we digitally alter photos? Are you talking about, are you comparing us to what's going on in the UK?
I'm doing due diligence.
凯特八卦新闻还传到白宫，不过白宫发言人只说祝凯特早日康复。 TVBS 新闻综合报道。
全球都在问凯特王妃在哪里。
This grainy photograph taken on Monday as Kate traveled to a private appointment with William.
修图风暴过后，凯特首度被拍到她跟威廉王储同车出门，不过身影很模糊，还是止不住外界的疑问。英国各大报的头版都是凯特，这张母亲节全家福官方照因为变造的痕迹太多，被国际媒体撤回。凯特只好声明道歉，承认跟大家一样，偶尔会修修片实验看看。
I think that just sort of tells everybody that she is healthy and she's okay.
She's not ready for that.And I think she needs to be left alone.
英国民众也帮忙缓颊，王室私下辩解说，官方照片修图或是挂上滤镜越来越常见。CNN 对这套说法完全不买账。
Where they put a Vogue cover she did a few years ago, and they just take a 6-second time lapse. They can go look at it themselves, and they say, "Oh, now it's her 2 years ago."
What I want to know is why nobody senior up the chain in the palace didn't say, "Hang on."
就连哈利王子的密友也跨海来补刀，说梅根是细节狂魔，绝对不会犯凯特的错，仿佛怕大家忘记凯特梅根素来妯娌不和。只是凯特手术之后健康沉迷，大英国协75周年庆祝的大日子，威廉王储单飞出席，王后卡蜜拉也带夫出征，查尔斯国王因为罹癌人没来，至少还有录影现身，就是独缺凯特王妃，恐怕只要他不公开露脸一天，外界对他的健康就更多猜想。体育前综合报道。
威廉镜头下的凯特儿女簇拥欢庆英国母亲节，社群曝光温馨照片，王室万万没想到却是提油救火。
Well, several major news agencies have withdrawn an image of Catherine. The photo has been manipulated.
多家主流媒体以新闻审查为由下架照片，因为在照片中至少看出五个疑点，包括夏绿蒂的毛衣修图修过头。
Kate isn't wearing her wedding ring, and their George has one of his, you know, his fingers crossed.
连评论员都乱了，乔治、路易分不清。而这回媒体直接打脸王室，而且修图变造也不是第一次。去年耶诞贺卡被网友翻出来，路易终止也消失，但外界最担心的是凯特已经两个月没公开露脸。
Quite a legitimate response is that they can't respond to conspiracy theories, you know, made up theories about what's really going on.
凯特腹部手术严重程度不明，英国陆军公布他六月将参加公公查尔斯官方生日的皇家阅兵仪式，但消息却突然从官网删除。
She had a full diary in December. We saw her, you know, up and about and around, and now having to stop all of these commitments.
白金汉宫也是多灾多难，上周末深夜惊传男子开车冲撞大门被逮，目前已排除涉及恐怖攻击，在安装新铁门前先用木板挡起来。 TVB 的新闻报道。
英国国王查尔斯今年2月罹癌，手术后多次出现在大众面前。反观英国凯特王妃，今年1月进行腹部手术后，已经神隐两个月，连一张照片也没有，大家都在问凯特到底病得有多重。
She wasn't due back in public until Easter at the very earliest. And this is a really different situation to those memorable photo calls outside the hospital each time she gave birth. You know, she's not taking this time out for fun.
凯特最后一次公开露面是去年圣诞节当天，当时她神采奕奕带着儿女参加礼拜，看起来毫无异状。然而威廉最近都形单影只，还在上周因为个人因素没有参加干爹的葬礼。凯特是否病重传闻四起，西班牙媒体报道指出，凯特可能罹患克隆氏症，是一种罕见的肠道疾病，也被称为不死的癌症，最常见的症状就是肚子痛，严重还可能导致死亡。
Kate, you know, is a future queen. She has no constitutional role. She's a mother of 3 young children, and she's going through a difficult process, so you can't really compare the two, but understandably there has been
白金汉宫虽然否认凯特罹癌，但没有说明更多细节。另外，根据 CNN 报道，卡米拉王后最近也告病假，皇室成员的健康接连出现状况。TVB 新闻综合报道。
国际媒体相当关注的还有另一件事，就是英国皇室凯特王妃的照片。而今天呢，凯特也针对了修改照片公开致歉了。有专家分析有说，修图原因恐怕是凯特术后仍在休养，没有办法环抱三个小孩，所以这是弄巧成拙吗？教授您怎么看英国皇室这一场公关危机？
是的，这确实是一场公关危机。我们看到这个新闻为什么会被大家放大镜来检视，可以从两个面向来看。第一个是凯特王妃之前的生病，其实英国王室对于凯特王妃或者是对于王室成员的隐私都保密到家，这导致了英国人民，尤其是对于目前的凯特王妃呢，其实她的人气是蛮高的，所以很多的小报或很多的媒体都在捕捉，都在试图的了解英国王室成员的健康状况，尤其是凯特王妃她的健康状况。这也导致了当凯特王妃要对外表达或者对外传递她的影像的时候呢，特别 有一层担忧，所以希望能够传递更比较正向的或者是比较好的照片。那当然做了一些，可能做出了一些变造或做出一些调整。那当然因为变造的可能细腻度不够，所以被发现或被质疑。所以我们说第一个面向是看英国民众对于王室的关注，尤其是对于凯特王妃的健康的状况有所关注。做了这样的一个照片的修正，是不是让大家更加的担心凯特王妃的身体的状况？这是第一个可以关注的焦点。那当然正向来说是民众很关注凯特王妃的健康。那第二个部分呢，其实更长远的来说，其实英国王室一直都在公关的问题上面要花很多的功夫，因为很多人都在用放大镜来检视。尤其我们知道王室过去可能家族成员之间的恩恩怨怨、恩怨情仇都拍成了戏剧，那现在王室进入到了所谓的数位时代，未来在公关的问题上面如何运用数位时代传递王室正向的形象。凯特王妃过去曾经以自己很自豪的是业余的摄影师，常常分享在社群媒体上面分享他的照片或者是分享他的家庭的照片。未来在数位时代如何能够确保精准的来分享他们王室成员的形象，然后又不至于在修图或者是修正一些照片传递正向形象的时候可能造成一些反效果，这是在数位时代英国王室必须要面临到的一些公关的挑战。当然啦，我们到目前为止哦，虽然大家有一些质疑，而且甚至媒体也把一些照片给撤掉了，可是至少到目前为止，新生代的王室成员呢，凯特王妃以及这个王储呢，事实上他在英国的形象还是挺正面的。我们当然从这样的一个消息当中可以看得出来，英国人民对于现在的王室还是蛮关注的，但是未来是不是在公关上面要再加以精进，这也是蛮值得思考的话题。尤其是名人到底如何来操作他们的社群形象，这个大概是现在全世界尤其在网络时代可能大家都在关注的话题。
提到影像，这次呢引发话题的是英国肯辛顿宫发布的凯特王妃照片，说是手术之后发布的第一张官方照片，各大通讯社在发布之后一天内纷纷下架，因为说源头经过调整，真实度未合格，似乎是含蓄的说这张照片看起来像是一个假照，假的变造照片。截稿前最新的消息是凯特王妃发文了，她说这个图是她自己修的，对于造成的混乱表示歉意。3月10日上午，来到英国白金汉宫大门口的游客们惊讶地发现眼前是一扇临时木板门，还有荷枪警察戒备森严。原来3月9日凌晨2点半，一名男子驾车冲撞这英国君主行政总部大门，伦敦警方表示不涉及恐怖攻击，男子受伤送医也被逮捕。不止外力冲击，英国皇室还因为核心成员健康问题受到打击。查尔斯国王与民众握手的景象短期内很难再见。3月11日的年度大英联邦日，查尔斯再度缺席。究竟他得了哪种癌症，必须休养治疗？白金汉宫对外始终讳莫如深。但外界分析，英国王室向来不乐见成员推卸职责，查尔斯不太可能因病退位。
I think abdication has become an almost a sort of dirty word in the UK, that it does imply a kind of shirking of responsibility. I think there might also be in part a sense that it's about protecting the next generation from as long as possible from the scrutiny and the relentless pressure of the press.
但媒体要给谁压力？人气与媒体喜好度由不得国王。英国皇室最得人喜爱的成员之一凯特王妃腹部手术的原因，外界也不知道。但三月十日，各大国际媒体争相刊登她手术后第一张公开照片，是肯辛顿宫发布的凯特王妃与三个孩子的合照。
Clearly, I think.Kensington Palace felt that they did have to put out a photograph of Kate to really stop some of this speculation.
I can appreciate that. And there, look at the picture. Look at the picture. She looks fine. She looks happy. She has got a fairly tight pair of jeans on, as far as I can see. She's sitting down. Perhaps she still has, as I say, discomfort with the muscles in her abdominal area. I have no idea what operation she had.
糟糕的是，这张照片竟在一天之内出现反效果，包括路透社、美联社、法新社与达智影像等国际知名通讯社和影像库纷纷宣布下架这张照片，请用户勿再引用，因为照片审查后未达合格标准。白话说就是，各大通讯社认为这张照片修图过头，真实性存疑，不想背书发布变造过的照片。对照照片刚发布时，英国皇室希望有的媒体效果，可谓适得其反。
Yes, she's a public figure, but yes, we all have a right to privacy about our medical details and conditions. And I just think, we need to stop.And let it be, and let the internet go wild and have a frenzy if it must do. But let us serious journalists take an objective and proper view of this.
各大通讯社确实严肃认真地检查照片，发现种种可疑细节。夏绿蒂公主的手腕宽过袖口，凯特王妃的左手上没戴婚戒，乔治王子左手无名指根部诡异隆起，路易小王子双腿影像怪异，后方的阶梯边缘竟接不起来，小王子的右手食指更维持一个抽筋般的奇怪角度。这张皇室宣称是威廉王子拍摄的家庭照，究竟是何时拍摄的也起人疑窦。照片背景中有棵像是椴树的植物，落叶乔木竟然在冷飕飕的英国三月满树绿叶。三月八日，威廉王子继续履行皇室公务，拜访伦敦南部一个板球俱乐部，谈笑风生，但形单影只。照片疑云如今越烧越大，各大通讯社说得委婉，怀疑照片在源头有被调整过，意有所指肯辛顿宫发布假照片。究竟是否凯特王妃的健康真的出问题，需要粉饰太平呢？英国王室从国王到太子妃都疑似病情严重，王后卡蜜拉没有人气，威廉王子家庭公务两头烧。落跑国外的哈利王子则忙着在美国做慈善。
These were very nice and compassionate people. He described them as being humble and down to earth during this visit.
哈利与梅根到德州陪伴两年前乌瓦尔德小学枪击案罹难教师的家人过生日，当地民众大赞这对前皇室夫妻亲切。英国民众曾抱怨皇室成员太多，浪费民脂民膏，没料到如今目睹快没人执行皇室公务的窘境。拒绝一辈子做备胎的哈利，他本人与一子一女继承英国王位顺位仍排在第五六七名，此时完全没有要回英国的迹象，被英国民众认为逃避责任也是意料中事。 TVBS 新闻综合报道。
英国凯特王妃换上全白短裙网球服和利落的马尾，与才刚退役的网球天王费德勒惊喜同框。
Shall we play some tennis?
Yes, please.
Let's do it.
身为全英俱乐部赞助人的凯特，为了即将开打的温网锦标赛宣传，难得下场和费德勒切磋球技。
Would you like to start or shall I start?
I think you should start, Roger.
费德勒率先发球，凯特王妃以一记制胜球赢得费德勒赞赏。
I think it was on the line. I think. Amazing.
Does it inspire you, any of you, to take up tennis?
Come on. Yes. Just because I'm here.
Yeah, exactly.
两人还展现温网具百年历史的严谨球童文化。事实上，费德勒不仅球童出身，他还曾亲自为乔治王子上过私人网球课。
Para el número uno siempre ha sido un.Un sueño, ¿no? Sigue siendo un sueño, aunque ya haya sido número uno. Y bueno, la verdad que poder ser top seed.
西班牙小蛮牛阿卡瑞兹周日对上乔科维奇，力量和精准度占上风的他，最终以6-4、6-4拿下草地赛冠军。在法网称王的乔科维奇，只当两星期的世界第一，球王宝座再度让出。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
带着
英国国旗头饰的女孩难得见到这大阵仗，表情略显紧张。只见凯特王妃亲切蹲下来安抚女孩。女孩霍凯特大拥抱，还哭了出来。参加完爸爸查尔斯三世的加冕仪式，周末王储威廉带着妻子凯特出来和英国人分享喜悦。
Yeah, and I've actually never seen Kate nor William in the flesh. They stood right in front of us and spent a long time talking to the people around us.
威廉还拿起啤酒和大家寒暄，夫妻俩超亲民。英国沉浸在国家盛典氛围，举办街头派对和午餐盛会。
Essentiellement faire la fête, qu'on soit français comme moi, qu'on soit britannique, qu'on soit australien, néo-zélandais, il y a un petit peu toutes les nationalités ici, des Suisses aussi.
首相苏纳克在唐宁街十号办午宴，招待美国第一夫人吉尔。全球总计有五万场午餐盛会共襄盛举。当晚，王室在温莎城堡也有加冕音乐会。Look at me.从美国歌手尼可舒辛格到凯蒂佩瑞，还有意大利知名男高音波切利和中国大陆钢琴家郎朗等人的表演，让查尔斯和卡米拉看得开心，藏不住喜悦。
As my grandmother said when she was crowned, coronations are a declaration of our hopes for the future. And I know she's up there, fondly keeping an eye on us, and she'd be a very proud mother.
威廉王子还代表王室发表演说，缅怀已故伊丽莎白女王，更表示对父亲获加冕感到骄傲，为加冕音乐会画下完美句点。TVBS 新闻就到。
国王加冕典礼第一排比主角查尔斯还要吸睛。观众席最前头，威廉一家目光马上就被凯特吸引。袍子下隐隐约约看到 Alexander McQueen 象牙白连衣裙，凯特身上首饰大有来头，水晶桂冠和珍珠耳环都是戴安娜生前最爱首饰，而袍子遮住的三层钻石项链也是当初乔治六世送给伊丽莎白二世的礼物。凯特同时穿出戴妃的优雅和已故女王的风范。说到王室，怎么可能忘了三位王子公主？五岁路易依然是表情包担当，打哈欠、嘟嘴、开口呐喊，全被镜头拍下来。相比之下，姐姐夏绿蒂一身白，稳重内敛表现被称赞有戴妃风采。据哥哥乔治，身为第二顺位继承人，扛下荣誉骑士重担，得帮爷爷提着长袍。而现场正要云集，美国第一夫人吉尔带孙女出席，英国首相、加拿大总理、法国总统都现身。其他亮点还包括饰演哈利波特麦教授的马基史密斯，美国歌手凯蒂佩瑞则是一身粉紫色出席，胸口还有皇冠项链。Not my king, not my king. 不过场外抗议声也不小。
In disbelief that it's really, you know, that we're living in this moment of authoritarianism.
不少示威者举牌高喊，要求废除王室。最后，至少52名示威者被警方逮捕。TVBS 新闻做报道。趁着爸爸查尔斯还在忙加冕典礼，英国威廉王储和太太凯特超亲民，搭地铁，目的地居然是一间小酒吧。
Not too bad at drinking pints, but putting pints in the
room. 和民众打成一片，这样的庆祝气息，伦敦随处可见，包括这尊超大型皇冠装饰。
We've put the installation in to enable people to celebrate the coronation of King Charles III, and to get up close and personal. Most people won't get that close to the coronation.
而白金汉宫外帐篷搭起来，早早卡位。
I'm just so excited. I'm like a 5-year-old at Christmas waiting to open my presents.
全身纪念品行头，国王加冕带来可观消费力。网络行销公司预估，三天加冕连假，英国零售消费渴望冲破80亿英镑，相当3000多亿台币。其中两个大宗是超市杂货和餐厅酒吧，而且食物你要贩售都会相当可观。
As an American, you don't really appreciate it until you get here.You know, once you live here, you kind of appreciate it. And, you know, I think the royal family's special, so I think...
I'm very enjoying for right now in London and some clicks my peaks for lifetime memories.
满满外国游客，饭店住宿全订满。
Events like this really kickstart the recovery, don't they? And they put Britain on the world stage again.
查尔斯三世加冕带动商机，从纪念品、餐饮到观光，各个摩拳擦掌。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
年纪小小就很识货，这位英国一岁幼童紧抓着黑色手提包不停把玩，一旁妈妈表情无奈，原来是从英国王妃凯特手上抢来。妈妈好说歹说，小朋友就是不愿放手，只是大方的凯特似乎毫不在意包包被抢走。只见小朋友玩腻了，手一甩，差点把包丢到地上，妈妈直冒冷汗，因为这颗鳄鱼纹包包不便宜，要价相当新台币2.6万元。凯特这趟随威廉王子下乡访问威尔斯，所到之处民众欢呼，两人没有王室架子，相当亲民。而王室成员这几天行程马不停蹄。
The coronation of King Charles III is upon us, and soon these streets will be filled with people coming to witness all the pomp and ceremony of a British royal event.
英王查尔斯三世5月6号登基加冕，人生头等大事前，查尔斯把握最后周末确认加冕使用的屏风。另外，白金汉宫也赶在仪式前公布最新用在活动上夫妇俩的照片。
What we've done is recreate the coronation for King Charles III, and we've had a gold-plated crown commissioned for the event.
即便加冕仪式细节仍未知，乐高乐园模拟当天情况，还制作出镀金皇冠，可见全国上下期待这场世纪盛典。TVBS 新闻做不到。
英国皇储凯特王妃步下坐车，手拿典雅黑色皮包，她可是出自我们台湾设计师之手，台塑王家王文阳的女儿 Grace 王思涵。凯特王妃好爱这款包，疫情间出席鼓舞民众时，甚至女王追思会这沉重场合，到后来代表王室出访威尔斯，五度拎着。王思涵这包叫 Later Love， 是英国情书包，像以前书信用来传递无私的爱。凯特王妃用这传递温暖给大众，感动到的包含王思涵本人。
开幕的时候刚好遇到疫情，所以那时候其实是很想放弃，很多的挫折。当凯特王妃拿的时候，我那天是一大早看到了新闻，然后就躲在厕所痛哭。
设计和努力被看见 ，Grace 喜极而泣。还有个原因，她的作品夹着许多对妈妈的爱，因为踏入皮革设计这条路，妈妈就是她的启蒙者。
第一个包包，你第一个手做包包就是要献给妈妈，对不对？虽然那时候她已经不在了。
其实后来回想起来，才发现原来这些美学都跟妈妈是息息相关。
王思涵的品牌 Grace Hand 从2011年创立，她的作品中有个经典皮革百褶包。你看这横向20公分的百褶包，得用120公分的皮革熨烫，成本重，难度高。起初没什么常想理它。蜿蜒设计路前段时间也首度在台湾以展览形态让大家看，爸爸王文阳他也到场。
他到现在有时候还在抱怨说，大学选择经济系是选择错误，是我叫他选的。所以他经济系毕业以后，就到我朋友的皮包厂，从基层做起。
从基层学做皮包，王思涵说，学徒那时没人看好他，觉得千金怎么做得久。整个心路历程在节目中回顾，特别接受主持人庄开文的专访介绍。
后来才发现，说是他们私底下几个同仁在打赌，说啊，这位千金应该一个礼拜一定就做不下去，
一个礼拜，
对，一个打赌一个礼拜，
是，
结果大家都输。
他的爸爸王文阳对掌上明珠的坚持和努力，虽然不舍，却也骄傲。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
威尔斯王妃凯特惊喜现身爱尔兰卫队训练基地，她接掌丈夫威廉王储的军职后，以爱尔兰卫队上校身份首度视察基地。
It's really good to see her. I think normally when we have seen her, it's been support of William.
凯特穿上军装，多了几分英姿飒爽，上半身迷彩军外套搭配针织上衣，下半身则穿同色系丹宁裤和军靴。一头利落的辫子，亲身演练救助伤兵，瞬间获得军中超高好感度。凯特周四在前往穆斯林社区，感谢土耳其强震救灾队。他手上拿着的包包引起关注，因为这是台湾设计师品牌 Grace Hand 的手提包，这也是凯特第五度在公开场合拿台湾设计师的包包。而这家公司是王永庆孙女王思涵创立的品牌。
不过凯特的公公查尔斯国王不时遭遇民众抗议，当场被质问为何要浪费纳税人的钱办加冕典礼。而英国《每日邮报》报道，查尔斯一度因为飞机声吵拒绝搬进温莎城堡，不过最后被王室说服，温莎堡已经着手进行整修，等着迎接五月的加冕典礼。TVBS 新闻综合报道。威廉凯特一下车，现场就响起一片欢呼声。凯特一袭荧光绿露肩礼服与现场的绿色地毯相互呼应。威廉夫妻一起出席为地球奋斗奖颁奖典礼，这个奖是由威廉创立，也是两人这一趟美国行的重头戏。这场颁奖典礼众星云集，就连威廉夫妇的好朋友前球星贝克汉也到场观礼。其实两人在白天已经马不停蹄赶行程，而且到哪里都受到美国人的热情欢迎。这位8岁小男童还特地打扮成英国的皇家卫兵前来献花，最后做出敬礼手势，可爱的模样把王储夫妇逗得超开心。男童母亲说，这套衣服10月就准备好了，原本是为了万圣节装扮用，后来听到威廉夫妇即将造访当地，决定再度换上卫兵装。从男童的表情看得出来，他对自己的造型很满意。
I'm going to scream to my BFF Baxter and tell them I'm famous.
欢迎威凯夫妇的，还有大老远就露出灿烂笑容的美国总统拜登。拜登还担心威廉穿得太少，双方热烈寒暄。白宫表示，两人还分享了对英国已故女王伊丽莎白二世的温暖回忆。TVBS 新闻于思颖综合报道。
站在爸妈威廉和凯特中间，才9岁的乔治小王子和妹妹夏绿蒂公主来送曾祖母最后一程。只见乔治小脸表情严肃，不时抿着嘴，双手紧握，夏绿蒂的手也交握着，看得出来有点紧张。之后在仪式中，乔治小王子好几次都被拍到抬起手抹抹眼角，像是在擦泪，让在场宾客看得都好心疼。
I think their composure was remarkable. I think the children in particular are extremely well behaved. I thought that it was a very difficult moment for all of them, particularly as they were walking in procession behind the coffin. It must have taken great courage to do that.
乔治今年是9岁，夏绿蒂7岁。之前威廉凯特坦言很挣扎要不要让小孩参加女王国葬，一方面是考虑到祖孙亲近，却又担心小孩情绪会无法负荷，如今决定让孩子们参加。
Yes, I think the Queen will be very gratified. She adored her great-grandchildren. And that, I think, really reflects how much they adored their grandmother, how close she was.
而乔治的出席不只是送别哀悼曾祖母，更是成为未来国王的点滴累积。
And Prince George is now second in line. He takes Prince William's spot. And really, this is his future, these great royal events.In which you have to grieve in public.
而乔治的父亲威廉王储这回多次在葬礼仪式中现身，都是紧皱着眉头。虽然没有在镜头前落泪，但是神情相当哀伤，看得出来，作为继位第一顺位的王储，威廉试着收敛情绪。
I think it was very important, though, that they were present today, not just as members of the family, but also as a symbol of continuity. King Charles is obviously much older than his mother was when she came to the throne.We have the new Prince of Wales, who's in his 40s. It's important to have a younger generation coming through as well.
尽管在女王国葬上看到年轻一代的威廉甚至乔治都到齐，象征团结一心，倒是新国王查尔斯三世难掩激动。尤其是当全场宾客唱起国歌，已经改为 God Save the King, 天佑吾王时，查尔斯是眼泛泪光。
He just looked incredibly pensive, very solemn. He has sat in that place so many times over the years and sung God Save the Queen to his mother, and suddenly the congregation is singing it for him, and she is no longer there, and that is a huge moment in his life.
另外一个焦点则是王室女眷们所佩戴的珠宝，也都是为了致敬女王。凯特佩戴的巴林珍珠耳环就是女王爱用的首饰之一，四层日本珍珠颈链，女王则是在1983年赴孟加拉的国事访问中曾经佩戴，还有夏绿蒂公主身上的马蹄形钻石胸针，也是女王赠予她的礼物，同时也被解读和女王热爱马匹有关。卡米拉王后没用相对低调的珍珠，而是选择了钻石和蓝宝石胸针。这副胸针是当年维多利亚女王的外孙送给祖母，庆祝她登基60周年的礼物。卡米拉这一次在国葬中佩戴，被认为是向伊丽莎白二世统治70年致敬，因为比维多利亚女王统治63年还要长久。而梅根佩戴的钻石珍珠耳环，则是女王在2018年赠予她的。所有的珠宝配饰都是从女王传承给下一代。
You can just see the special connection that every single member of that family has with the Queen. You know, she was a mother, of course, she was a grandmother, but she was also part of the institution. She represented the institution. I mean, this is a family, but it's also a family business.
除了珠宝之外，哈利没有穿军服出席，也没能行军礼，这一幕就让有些民众为哈利抱不平。而梅根这一次依旧顶着烟熏妆出席，只是最后还被拍到了眼角一抹泪痕，甚至还被说连底妆都哭花了。不管之前风风雨雨，至少在此刻，王室后代们在女王国葬上真情流露，告别他们最爱的一家之主。 TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。